noticed in the previous videos, we do have a little sort of bar on the left side. Kind of Mac OS like, but not so much. There's no zoom, it's a little different. But it's very, very cool, very functional, and very efficient to have. It's called the Unity Bar. And it's called the Unity Bar because it unifies the whole system onto this little left bar here. In fact, you'll notice the left side of this screen is used more often than the right side over here. For instance, when we're, let's say, opening up a window. Sorry about that. When we're opening up a window, you see that the controls are up here for closing, minimizing, and maximizing. And as far as everything else, you also have the file edit up in this corner here as well. You have the ability to search your system here. And you have your icons here. So the left side of the system is all in this one little corner. And it's what you'll be using most of the time. Back here, I mean, if you have a Bluetooth device, you can use that. If you're recording a desktop, that's what it'll be. Volume. And a few actually little pieces here and there. You'll rarely come across this side. For a few things here and there, you'll rarely come there. But keep in mind, or keep a focus, that the left side is very useful. It's all about control of the current window or the current system. While the right side is more social, music, chat, stuff like that, and information. Actually, consider this just the information area. There you go. So they have Bluetooth is on. That's enough information. We have the volume all the way up. You have the date and time. You can set your availability for accounts. And you have a few things such as the lock screen, guest session, switching from tutorials, which is the username I call myself right now, or log out, suspend, and all these extra little pieces here. So this is the information area called the notification, while this side is more of the control aspect. So this bar here, as you can see, icons live on it. The best way to actually get an icon on here is simply just to search it. So we're going to go ahead and get Shotwell. So simply going over to application or any application that you have in this little window, I'm going to click and hold, and now I can drag it. I can drag it straight onto this dock here, and I can organize it anywhere I want. If I don't like the position here, what I want to do is hold down on the mouse again for about a few seconds and just kind of hover over it and then start moving it again. If you hold and move, you'll see it kind of scrolls. And this is very great. This is actually a good thing. I love this little idea of it. Because now we can literally have applications upon applications. Let's go ahead and show the applications menu. So I can basically open up a bunch of applications straight from this menu. And you can see how these little pieces are folding in the bottom. These little folds are just going to be a compression, basically. If I hover over this area, it'll expand in respect to this area. If I hover here, you see how it doesn't expand as much. But if I go down here, it expands in respect to where I want to go, which is great. This is really, really well with touchscreens. With touchscreens, this feels like a little scroll area. I've used it before, but so far touchscreens aren't completely stable yet. I'm going to go ahead and close these out. Also on this area, you have a little workspace switcher. The little workspace switcher, simply put, click on it. You have four desktops available to you by default. So if I want to open up this window, I want to open up a Firefox, and I can literally manage these windows straight from the workspace switcher. So I can put this here, put this there, put this there, and just organize myself in whatever way I want. I can double click on one to get there, and I can simply switch back and forth between them, just like so. Another very easy way to switch is going to be Control Alt on your keyboard, and then you press the left, right, or right, left, down, right, and up arrows, and this will kind of switch you back and forth with a little animation right in the middle of the screen letting you know which desktop you're focused in at the moment. That's a great way to get yourself organized. Get yourself, especially if you have, I don't know, a web browser in one, a bunch of documents in the other, maybe some music in the other, so on and so forth. As far as the very top here, this is going to be the overall Unity search, I want to call it. It'll search everything on your computer. Files, applications, basically everything that lives on your computer, you can search it from here. So if I want to go ahead and search documents, it's a bit of a lag. Maybe that wasn't working out very well. Okay, documents. If I want to spell it right too. So this will give me the application for document writing, an application for looking at the different kind of text I can put in a document, scanning physical documents and putting them on the computer, or searching for other files related to documents, or more detailed searching is what this would be. Or I can just go into the documents folder where all my documents are supposedly held. And it's also a little, I guess, launch pad for a few apps. You can do a media apps search. So you have movie players, desktop recorders. It says Handbrake. It's an application to convert different file formats. Very useful for video and other stuff like that. VLC media player, Pi TV video editor. These are my most commonly used, as you can see, most frequently used. Use this installed overall. This is what I have in the top. And if I click on this little see more, I see a few more extra options. And at the very bottom, you have apps available for download. So you're not limited to these here. These are also available online for you to download, which is great. This is great for expanding your horizon on application availability, what you can do your computer for. Very good for finding potential in a computer that you never thought it would be able to do something other than going to Facebook. And this is the same for everything else. This is a quick little launch pad for some applications. This is all the applications on your computer. These are my frequently used. I can click on the See Viewer, See More. This is my frequently used at the moment. I can see all of the installed 98 applications available on my computer. A lot of them are Settings, Evolution. It's just a bunch of different applications available to me. That's a bit inefficient. There's so many applications, it's hard to find a specific one if I want looking for it. So if I want to look for, let's say, my GIMP application for editing images, I can just go in this All Applications area. Oh, popped away. I can click on the little arrow and go to Multimedia. Or hold on, Graphics even. That's even more pinpoint. So I can go to Graphics and there it is, my GIMP image editor. And this is all under installed. I can also just search GIMP and it'll be right there for me. So if you know the name, just type it in. If not, you can go ahead through this little menu and pinpoint all the different applications and their categories and find out a lot about, I mean, what you have, really. This is a great way to organize everything. And again, with each different category in the very bottom, you also have a little suggested app downloads, no matter where you go. Underneath the applications can be this little plus magnifying glass. The files and folders is going to be a little file with a magnifying glass. This works the exact same way. You have a file or folder name, type it in, you'll find it. You have a recent up here, or most used. You have your favorite folders up here. And if you want to pinpoint to a certain location or a certain kind of folder, you can go on this little sidebar, pressing the arrow, and pinpoint to the area. In this case, I don't have any documents in my home folder. Let's see, folders, I have the tutorials folder, which is my home folder. I'll explain the home folder later on. Images, no images in my home folder. This is a blank user, so it's not much of anything. You see I have videos here of all my edits and all my recordings. So of course that's there. And this is how you can simply search for the files available in your home folder. Very good, very quick, and you also have a recents, which is really nice to have, especially if you're working on a bunch of files in the current moment. Also, when you have applications, or when you have a USB, let's say, or any external hard drive or CD, it'll pop up at the bottom here, it'll pop up right here as well, and it'll pop up in the folder area right here. So you have three different accesses to the same device. Whichever one's closest to you at the moment, that's the one you're going to use, but that's where it's going to be located at, especially in this little bar. And the very bottom here is going to be the trash. Simply click on it. We have all the trash inside already. This is where you will literally drag and drop a file. Let's say I'll show you right here. Drag and drop this file right to the trash down here. Boom, throws it away. One thing to also know, which is really neat, if you have, and there's a big one I had earlier, if you have a file, you want to open it. You see how all of these are not, are all dark except the trash can? That means only the trash can interact with this type of file. But if we have, let's say, VLC available for us, and now I want to open it up, you see how now VLC is also is the only one that's available to go? And you, when you hover over it, you have a little plus sign on it. See the difference there? That means I can literally just let it go on top of that, and that'll actually open it up. But I'm not going to go ahead and go through that, because I've already heard myself hate my voice, so I'm going to go ahead and pass that opportunity. But it's very good. If you have a file and you're not sure what it is, go through your little bar here, see which application opens it. Great to have a little experiment and see what actually that file is. When you're done, or when you want to empty the trash and clear it up, clean some space on your computer, simply click the empty trash up here, then empty trash right here, and boom, all gone. And that's a little bit about the sidebar. I'll go ahead and explain a little bit more about the desktop later on. I'll go ahead and stop here, and I'll go into this little section here next.